In this video, we are going to talk about something that can be very confusing for both the new fish keeper and even the experienced fish keeper alike, and that is how to choose the right filter for your aquarium, so stay tuned. So we have done a lot on fish tank filtration. We've talked about different types of filters. We've compared different filters. We've done a lot of filter reviews. So if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. We've got over 65 fish tanks in our fish room. We've always got something going on. So one of the questions we get asked a lot is, what type of fish tank filter should I use? And the answer to that is, it depends on your needs. Often when we're watching videos or reading reviews, it seems like the filter that's being reviewed is the best filter on the market, and that is the one that you need to make your fish tank all that it can be. And what we want to do in this video is talk about the different types of filtrations, because there may not be a best filter. It really depends on your specific needs. There are lots of different types of filters out there. There's hang-on-the-back filters and canister filters and sponge filters and box filters and matting filters and under-gravel filters and sumps, and the list just goes on and on and on, and this can get super confusing. So the first thing, let's talk about something simple, and that is the sponge filter. Now, these happen to be Aquarium Co-op sponge filters. We've been using these more and more in our fish room. Really like them. I'll put a link down in the description below if you want to check them out. But a sponge filter. Now, we've done videos on how to clean sponge filters. We've done comparisons with other types of filtration. I'm going to put all of our filtration videos down in the description below if you want more information. Now, if you've been watching the channel for a while and you've looked at our fish tanks, you will know the vast majority of our fish tanks are filtered exclusively with these. And these are sponge filters. Why do we use them? We use them in our fish room because, as I mentioned already, we have a lot of fish tanks in our fish room. Over 65, and because we have so many tanks, it's impossible to supply enough power down here to power hang-on-the-back filters or any other type of filter for all of our different fish tanks. The nice thing about this, and we did a fish room tour a long time ago where I talked about the types of filtration that we use and why, how we set it up. I'll put that in the upper right hand corner as well as in the description below. It's a very old video, but it gives you some background as to why we chose this. And the bottom line is, when you're running a lot of fish tanks, this often, sponge filters are often the most economical way. And the reason for that is, you can have one pump that supplies air to your entire fish room. It saves a lot on energy. These are super simple to clean. They're very inexpensive. The nice thing, especially if you've got a fish room where you're going to be doing a lot of breeding, or you've got tanks that are going to be doing, you're going to have a lot of fry, you don't have to worry about fry getting sucked up. This is a very simple structure, a very simple mechanism. You just pump air, water goes through, and you've got beneficial bacteria here that's going to allow you to complete the nitrification process, ammonia to nitrite, nitrite to nitrate. Now, these filters are also going to do a pretty good job of mechanical filtration, probably not the best on our list. In fact, it's going to be about mid-range. So pulling stuff out of the water, it's going to do an okay job, especially if you properly maintain these. But it's also going to do a really awesome job at biological filtration. Again, that ammonia cycle thing that you hear about. So these are really, really good. They're more than sufficient for mechanical, and also very good for biological filtration. The downside is, if you're looking for chemical filtration, so you put media in a filter that's going to allow you to remove some of the impurities, that this is not going to do it for us. So this is a really awesome option for breeding for lots of fish tanks. That's the reason why we use so many of them. Now, like the sponge filters, there are other options. Here's a matten filter. We get these from Flip Aquatics. Again, I'll put a link down in the description below. We've done comparisons on matten filters versus sponge filters before, but they're air driven. The same would be true of a box filter or an under gravel filter. All of those things may be useful if you're running multiple tanks or you're going to be breeding a lot. And so often when I talk about sponge filters and matten filters, people think, well, this must be my favorite filter. After all, when you look around the fish room, this is the vast majority of our filtration. And I say, not so fast. There are other really good filters, but again, it depends on your specific needs. So here we have a hang-on-the-back filter. This happens to be the Seachem 55. We're going to be doing an update video on this particular filter in the not-too-distant future. We've done an unboxing of this filter. It's been a good filter. This is, again, it's a Seachem 55. It's a hang-on-back filter. So why would I choose this? This actually would be my go-to type of filter, a hang on back filter, if I were running, let's say, maybe 10 tanks or less. I really like hang on the back filters. I find them extraordinarily easy to maintain and to set up, and because of the ease of maintenance, I really like them. And so if I had a smaller fish room, and in fact, until we built out this side of the fish room, we used hang on the back filters, mostly Marinelands, but they worked out great. All you have to do is pull the filter floss or your sponge out of the back, change that every couple of weeks. It works out really, really well. Also, when it comes to cost, it's a very inexpensive way to filter tanks. Now, it's going to be more expensive than, let's say, sponge filters, especially if you've got multiple fish tanks. However, if you're just dealing with a few, a hang on the back filter, relatively low cost, does a really good job of biological filtration, just like the sponge filters do, but also does, these things do a much better job of mechanical filtration because you can put things like filter floss or sponge in the compartments in the back, and that can trap a lot more debris. This also gives us the option of doing some chemical filtration, which the sponge filters will not allow us to do. So maybe we put some media in there that will lower ammonia or nitrite. Now, when it comes to noise, these things can be pretty good. It depends on the types of filters. More and more, like the Seachem, like the newer Marineland filters, the Aquion Quiet Flows, they have internal filters. The impeller is internal. It's inside the tank, which makes them very, very quiet. Sponge filters, when it comes to noise, when you're dealing with an air-driven system, the pump itself is going to make a little bit of noise. And depending on how much flow you have coming out of the sponge filter, you're going to hear some bubbling, but that's about it. So it's kind of nice. Now, if you have older hang-on-back filters, or they get dirty, or if the motor is outside of the fish tank, sometimes these can be a little bit noisier. So that's something to keep in mind if you've got a fish tank, let's say, in a bedroom. You'd probably want to go with a filter with an internal motor to keep the noise down. The problem, of course, is going to be when you have a setup like ours, we still use hang-on-the-back filters on a few tanks that are heavily stocked, more so just to pull stuff out of the water, mechanical filtration, but these are going to require more energy. So if you've got 10, 15, 20 tanks and you're running these exclusively, you're going to need a lot more outlets, and you're going to be pulling a lot more power out of that room, out of those outlets, compared to a single air pump in a system where you can just have one pump driving air throughout all your filters. The other disadvantage may be when it comes to breeding, these have a tendency to suck up fry or shrimp. Now, you can certainly get around that very easily by using an intake sponge, and that will cut down on that quite a bit. The other type of filter that you may want to consider is the internal canister filter. So this would actually go in a fish tank. This is a Marineland Magnum internal canister filter. So the benefits of this is it's not taking up any space outside of the tank. This goes right in the tank itself. Because it's going to be in the tank fully submerged, it's going to be relatively quiet. Usually these are going to provide quite a bit of flow, and so you can have directional flow with this thing. If there's some disadvantages, you're going to have this thing, this bulky contraption sitting inside the tank, which isn't that much different than a sponge filter. And again, this is something similar to a hang-on back filter. The disadvantage is it just takes up a little bit more space. Cost is going to be very similar. They're going to be a little bit quieter than most hang-on-the-back filters because, like I said, they're inside the tank. The only disadvantage maybe is, or one of the disadvantages is going to be that you have to eventually change out the media, and because this whole thing is inside the tank, that might be a little bit more cumbersome than, let's say, a hang-on-the-back filter. I would love to hear from you down in the comments section below. What is your favorite type of fish tank filter and why? So let's talk a little bit about why you might want to choose a canister filter for your filtration methods inside your aquarium. I think the first thing is you can hide canister filters a lot more easily. The filter itself goes under the tank, and all you're seeing in the tank usually is a return and the actual intake itself. And so it can be very well hidden, unlike sponge filters or matten filters or the internal canister filters where you're going to see that stuff in the tank. And some people just don't like that. So when you look at our 50-gallon Lowboy, we actually chose a canister filter for this tank because it's more of a show tank, and I didn't want bulky filtration in the aquascape or hanging off the side of the tank. So the only filtration that you actually see is the return and the intake, and that is it. It's also really quiet. Most canister filters are going to be relatively quiet. Not all of them are, but the vast majority are. you also get a lot of space for filter media. These are going to be filters that are really awesome at all three mechanisms, or all three types of filtration. Mechanical filtration, biological filtration, and chemical filtration gives you a lot of space inside the filter to customize it to your needs. Now, the downside is going to be that you're going to pay for that ability to customize your filter. Often, of the filters we've talked about so far, canister filters are going to be the most expensive when you're looking at a gallons per hour kind of flow through. So it's not unusual to see canister filters for larger tanks like the Fluvols, the Eheims, going for $200, $300, $400 easily. But the one thing I will say when it comes to a canister filter, if I've got a large display tank, it's probably the only way I would go. I wouldn't want to have hang-on-the-back filters hanging off the back. I wouldn't want sponge filters visible. I think a canister filter would be a really nice way to go. Now, of course, the downside is going to be having to clean these things. Unlike hang-on-the-backs, unlike sponge filters, which are super easy to clean, just takes a minute or so, cleaning canister filters, while not impossible, is by far, of the different types of filters that we've talked about so far, the most cumbersome, the most involved, and therefore a lot of people neglect cleaning them. And so because of that, they will often do a worse job of filtration if you're not properly maintaining them. But if they're properly maintained, they can be pretty awesome at all types of fish tank filtration. The last one I want to talk about, and that is the sump. Now, we do not and have never run sump systems in our fish room. That's not to say that we won't. They can be very useful for a number of reasons. Sumps often give you the most potential, the most volume for filtration. So you can do a lot with a sump. You can customize it to your needs. Here, what we're seeing is a sump that Tim built when we did his fish room tour. You can see he's got a lot of different stuff in here. So you can put biomedia, you can put micron filters. People sometimes will grow plants inside their sumps, and that will take care of some of the nitrates. So there's a lot of different things here. You can put chemical media in here as well for chemical filtration. There's just so many different options. This can be a very low cost project, or it can be a very expensive project depending on what you do with your sump. The other thing that you have to consider is with a sump, often people will drill their tanks, and not everybody is comfortable drilling their tanks or buying a tank that's drilled and worrying about bulkheads that leak. For the most part, it's going to be fine, but it's just a concern that you might not have with other types of filtration. The other interesting thing about a sump is you could potentially hook it up to multiple tanks. And in fact, in Tim's fish room, that's what he's done. He's got a sump that filters an entire wall of tanks. Now, the downside to that could be if you wind up with disease in one of those tanks that's hooked up to that filtration system, the rest of those fish are going to be exposed to those parasites as well. So when it comes to choosing the right fish tank filter, do what best suits your needs. Make the selection based on your needs. For us, the only viable option we have is to have an air-driven system. That means matten filters and sponge filters or box filters, and that's what we've done because it would become completely impossible to use other types of filtration. However, if I had fewer tanks, let's say 10 or less, I would probably switch all my sponge filters off and run hang-on-the-back filters. Just because I like the ease of use, I would prefer to pull the sponge filters out of the tanks so that's not actually in my aquascape. And the cost is not too bad. If I had display tanks, I wouldn't put hang-on-the-back filters on my display tanks. I would use a canister or a sump because I would want my filtration to be more hidden. I would want more flow through gallons per hour, and I would want the ability to have more surface area given that my tank is probably going to be on the larger side. So I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, share, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one.